Welcome friends, let us go for the discussion of another lesson of inorganic chemistry, that is oxygen family. This oxygen family is having total 6 electrons in the valence shell, hence it is also known as 6th A group. As we know the reason why a particular group is known as A group, because the valence electrons are present in just in either s orbitals or s and p orbitals combination. If it is so, then such kind of all the things are said to be A group. Here also total 6 electrons are there, and those 6 electrons are present in s and p orbitals combination, hence it is said to be 6th A group. As being the head of the family is oxygen, it is also known as oxygen family and also known as oxygen and the sulfur family. And most of these elements present in this group, oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium and polonium. Polonium is radioactive. After leaving the polonium, remaining elements, the first four elements, oxygen, sulfur, selenium and the tellurium, generally forms the minerals. Hence these are known as mineral forming elements, and we can say it is also ore forming elements. The other name given for the ore forming of these elements are chalcogens. The meaning of chalcogens are ore forming elements. Generally the ore is present in many varieties of counter ions, like oxide ion with respect to the oxygen of this group. Similarly, oxygen combination with the carbon, carbonates CO3 2-, bicarbonates HCO3-, similarly sulfur related ores, sulfides S-2 and sulfates SO4 2-, such kind of ores are there. Let us go for the oxide ores. What are the oxide ores present inside the natural oxide? O-2 is present as a counter anion and it is connected with the cation. So there are aluminium oxides, bauxite Al2O3, tin oxide SnO2, similarly here chromium oxide, that is chromite Cr2O3 followed by FeO combination, and manganese oxide which is known as pyrolusite, and ferrous related oxides, that is hematite Fe2O3, ferrous in the +3 oxidation state. Similarly, magnetite, which is a mixed oxide, Fe3O4, followed by copper-related oxide, cuprite, Cu2O, and zinc-related oxide, zincsite, ZnO. These are all are oxide as the anion-containing ores, or the minerals, which are known as oxide ores. Similarly, the carbonate ores are there, sulfide ores are there, and the sulfate ores are there. Have a look over these kind of ores as an introduction part of this 6th A group elements. Yes, the other ores like carbonate ores are there in which oxygen is there, and the major carbonate ores, those are magnesium, calcium, ferrous, copper and zinc is present in the form of its corresponding carbonates. Here magnesium carbonate, which is known as magnesite, and calcium carbonate, generally known as lime, and calcium and magnesium combination is also available in nature, that is said to be dolomite. Similarly, this is ferrous carbonate, which is known as siderite, and the copper carbonate exists in two ways, copper carbonate followed by copper hydroxide, that is said to be malachite. Similarly, 2:1 ratio of copper carbonate and the copper hydroxide is said to be what? Azurite. These are all are the carbonate ores. Similarly, sulfide also forms different varieties of ores, and they are also maximum in number. Lead forms here, ferrous, copper, silver, and the zinc forms the corresponding sulfides. Here the lead combination with the sulfide, which is available in nature, is said to be lead sulfide. That lead sulfide is known as galena. Similarly, ferrous in combination with the sulfide, which is known as pyrites, iron pyrites, FeS2. Similarly, here copper pyrites is there. Copper pyrites is Cu2S, and copper gland, copper pyrites, copper glands is Cu2S, and copper pyrites is Cu2S in combination with Fe2S3 combination, that is said to be copper pyrites. Similarly, silver sulfide is there, that is known as silver glands. Similarly, ZnS is known as, that is known as zinc blend, ZnS. Along with this sulfide ore, there are sulfate ores, and the naturally available sulfate ores are consisting with the copper, calcium followed by the barium, whereas calcium sulfate and also barium sulfates are available. This calcium sulfate is said to be 2H2O, is said to be gypsum, and barium sulfate is said to be what? Barytes. Thus, the majority of the elements of the 60 group elements are forming the minerals of the different varieties of the metals and ores of the different varieties of the metals. Because these are more electronegative, always forms the anions. Hence, these are responsible for the ores. As being these are responsible for the ores and the minerals, these of all are known as what? Chalcogens. And the carbonate of zinc, which is known as zinc carbonate is known as calumet. If you look at here, magnesium, calcium, secondary group elements, followed by ferrous, copper, zinc, order wise D black elements. Similarly, here lead, fourth group element, after lead, ferrous, copper family, followed by zinc. And here calcium and the barium. Thus, easy way to remember the ores, which are helpful for the metallurgical operations also. Next is position in periodic table. These elements are present at the right portion of the periodic table, and these are present in between the nitrogen family as well as the halogen family, that is fluorine. And these elements are oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium and the polonium. Out of these 5 elements, polonium is radioactive element. Except polonium, remaining all elements are non-radioactive, and these are generally known as ore forming elements, otherwise the mineral forming elements. On behalf of majority of the elements are forming ores and the minerals, hence these are said to be the chalcogens. These are once again oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium and the polonium. Now let us go for the electronic configuration and the other properties associated with the 50A group elements, 60A group elements. The list of elements and the names and the corresponding electronic configurations. Elements are oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium and the polonium, whereas polonium is radioactive element. The symbols given for the elements are oxygen O, sulfur S, selenium Se, tellurium Te and polonium Pu. Whereas the general electronic configuration is Ns2Np4. It belongs to second period and this is third and this is sixth period, etc. The period number, this is second period, this is third period and this is fourth period, this is fifth and the last one is of sixth period. So therefore, the second period total capacity is 8, and in order to reach second to third also it maintains 8 as the difference. Hence the electronic configuration is Ns2Np4, that is 2s2 2p4, 3s2 3p4, 4s2 4p4, whereas as per n plus l value is concerned, 4s followed by 3d all are having equal in energy level, hence it is associated with 3d10. Here 5s2 5p4, 6s2 6p4. This includes 4D, this includes 5D, followed by what? 4F14. Thus, with the nearest inert gas configuration, if we write the electronic configuration, that is helium followed by 2S2 2P4, neon followed by 3S2 3P4, argon followed by 3D10, 4S2 4P4, krypton followed by 4D10, 5S2 5P4, and xenon followed by 4F14, 5D10, 6S2 and 6P4. Whereas the atomic number difference is second period to third period, in order to reach it makes a difference of 8. So therefore atomic number here 8 followed by 16 followed by 34 followed by 52 and the 84. Here the difference is 8 because second period maximum capacity is 8 because 2s2 2p6 is there, whereas third period maximum capacity is 18. So therefore here it is 18 and here it is 18 once again. Here it is 32 because it is fifth period, which also includes the 4D level also. 4D level consisting of extra 10 electrons followed by 4F14, that is 14 electrons are extra. So therefore here that 18 plus 14, 32 difference. So therefore 8 and 16 difference is 8, 16 and 34 difference is 18, 52 and 84 difference is 32. Whereas the general electronic configuration as we discussed, it is Ns2Np4. Whereas s orbital is having 2 electrons, as per Hund's rule is considered after upfilling of all the things. The fulfillment takes place Thus here this is the electronic configuration. That is, in the valence shell, what happens is s orbital is completely filled. Then out of 3 p orbitals, 1 p orbital is filled and remaining 2 orbitals are having unpaired electrons. This is the general electronic configuration. And the penultimate number of electrons, if we count once, that is after leaving this 2s2, 2p4, and the before that one, that is helium related configurations, outermost shell in this, that is consisting of oxygen 2 electrons, whereas here sulfur 8 electrons, selenium 18 electrons, tellurium 18 electrons, and polonium is also consisting of what? 18 electrons in it. Due to these reasons, see, electronic configuration is common for everything, outer electronic configuration, that is ns2 and the np4, that's what these are having similarity. And moreover, in this, the set of selenium, tellurium, polonium maintains one particular penultimate electronic configuration, so therefore these three behaves differently and oxygen sulfur behaves differently. And in this case of oxygen and sulfur also, oxygen is having 2 electrons, sulfur is having 8 electrons in the penultimate shell. Due to this reason, they also differ from one another. Thus, as a whole, they are having similarity, and in that similarity, oxygen sulfur behaves in one way, and remaining selenium, tellurium and polonium behaves in another different way. Moreover, that set of oxygen and sulfur are also differed from one another because the penultimate number of electrons are not same. Oxygen is consisting 2 electrons, whereas sulfur is consisting 8 electrons. Due to this reason, the penultimate number of electrons are different. Due to this reason, the properties of oxygen and sulfur are also differed to certain extent. This is the basic introduction related to the 6th A group elements. This particular issue can be represented in the form of a diagram also. Due to having of similar electronic configuration, all these behaves an order, all these behaves similarity in properties, whereas due to difference in penultimate number of electrons, sulfur, except sulfur, selenium, tellurium and polonium behaves in one way, whereas oxygen and sulfur behaves in another way. Moreover, here also the penultimate number of electrons are different. Due to this reason, oxygen behaves something differently from the sulfur, sulfur behaves something differently from the oxygen. These two are once again makes different from the other. As a whole, this set of 5 elements will behaves with the similarity in electronic configuration, similarity in properties from one another. Next is occurrence of the 6th A group elements. Oxygen, it is the most abundant of all the elements present in the periodic table. And in the atmosphere, oxygen is the major constituent with which only the living system is surviving. Whereas the composition portion in the atmosphere is 20.9% by weight, whereas as for the volume is concerned, it is 20.9% by volume, and weight is concerned, this is of 23%. And in the earth crust, it is present in the form of its corresponding oxide ores, carbonate ores and the bicarbonate ores that we made the discussion. In this way, oxygen is generally present. In the atmosphere, oxygen is also present in the form of its allotropic form, that is ozone. In the form of ozone also it is present. As being it is having heavier weight compared to the nitrogen, the weight percentage of oxygen is greater compared to its volume percentage. That's what by volume it is approximately 21%, but by weight it is reaching to a position of 23, because average weight of oxygen is greater compared to the nitrogen, which is the major constituent of the atmosphere. Let us go for the sulfur, how sulfur is distributed. Sulfur is not that much present as compared to the oxygen in the atmosphere. It is present in the earth crust, that is in the form of minerals and the ores. Generally those are sulfides as well as the sulfate ores. And also it is present in the earth underground beds in the form of elemental sulfur. And the another one major source of the sulfur is H2S gas, and that H2S is also present in crude oil as well as the natural gas. And in living system also, sulfur is present in the combined form, just like amino acids, proteins, and enzymes are also constructed with the help of sulfur atoms. And remaining elements like selenium and the tellurium, these are present in the form of their corresponding tellurides as well as the selenides, that is Se2- and the Te2-. These are said to be selenides as well as the tellurides, and these are present as impurities along with the sulfide ores. Whatever the sulfur is there in the earth crust, it is present in the form of sulfide ores, whereas in these sulfide ores, with the traces amounts or the little amounts are in the form of impurities, selenoids as well as the tellurides are present. Whereas the major, though they are minor in quantity, the major source of the selenoids as well as the tellurides is the anodic mud, that is technically known as what? Here, SIME, S-L-I-M-E, anode SIME of electrolytic refining of the copper is consisting majorly the selenoids as well as the tellurides, that is Se-2 and the Te-2 related anions with the counter cations are present in the anodic mud of the electrolytic refining of copper. In this way, in nature, in atmosphere, in earth crust, and wherever the earth related natural living systems are there, in that the distribution related to the 6A group elements, how oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, and the no more discussion related to the polonium, which is radioactive, how they are distributed is like this. Now we will go for the occurrence we found. Now we will go for abundance related to the 6A group elements in the nature. Next one is abundance. Abundance implies how percentage wise the most percentage availability containing element is which one, such kind of information. Out of these of all, polonium is radioactive, hence there is no more discussion, and remaining elements oxygen, sulfur, selenium and the tellurium. Now here the abundance, if you look at, oxygen is most popular, compared to oxygen sulfur is the second position out of these, and after sulfur selenium, and the next one is tellurium. As per the percentage of abundance in the earth crust is concerned, oxygen is most abundant and the tellurium is the least abundant element. General properties. Properties related to the 6A group elements like physical state, atomic radii, metallic nature, melting and boiling points, ionization potential, electron affinity, electron negativity, catenation, allotropic property, oxidation states, multiple bonds and reactivity. These are all comes under the general properties of the 6A group elements. The first one is the atomic radii. First one is physical state and the atomicity. Physical state, if I go for the elements related to the 6A group, oxygen, sulfur, selenium and all other. Oxygen is a gas. It is present in the atmosphere. Under room temperature condition, oxygen is a gas. Whereas sulfur is a solid, selenium is a solid. Hence, the physical states of the oxygen gas, sulfur, selenium, tellurium and all others are solids. Whereas oxygen is a diatomic molecule, in between the two oxygen atoms, double bond is present. One is sigma bond and second one is pi bond. Because that p orbital is smaller in size, because that is 2p orbital, 2p orbitals which are smaller in size, whereas the distance present between the atoms is also small, when they overlap laterally, then the maximum portion of the orbitals will be overlapped, which is having one unpaired electron. Thus, oxygen is a diatomic gas. The 2p orbital, which is smaller in size, when overlaps with one another, the maximum content of the p orbitals will be overlapped laterally. Thus, it leads to the formation of a strength and attraction, which is considered as a bond. But in case of the remaining p orbitals of the sulfur, selenium, they are bigger in size. So they are widely spread in the three-dimensional space. The overlapping interaction eligible volume is very little. Hence, it not offers a strength and interaction, thus it not able to form any kind of pi bonds. So therefore, oxygen forms the pi bonds. As a result, the two oxygen atoms are connected by satisfying all the valencies by getting the octet configuration. Whereas, in between one molecule and the other molecule, the intermolecular forces of attractions are weak. Due to this reason, oxygen is existing in the form of gas. But whereas sulfur and all other elements which are unable to form the sigma bond, unable to form the pi bonds, they just forms the sigma bonds to make it satisfy the octet configuration. Thus, more sulfur atoms can be connected with one another. As a result, here 8 sulfur atoms can connect with one another in the form of a Packard ring. Similarly, selenium is also existing with 8 selenium atoms are connected with one another. The shape of that ring is Packard ring structure. Thus, atomicity of the oxygen is 2, sulfur is 8, selenium is 8, and remaining is also 8. So, therefore, thus, the physical state and the atomicity both are interconnected with one another. The more the atomicity of the molecule, the more the weight. The more the weight implies, the higher the size. The higher the size implies, the more the intermolecular force of attraction. As a result, solid may be the physical state. Thus, the same trend is maintained over here. Oxygen is present in the gaseous state, whereas sulfur and selenium, due to having of maximum atomicity, they maintains solid as the physical state. Thus, oxygen is gas, atomicity 2, and remaining all elements with the Packard ring structure, atomicity, by maintaining an atomicity of 8, they are having solid in physical state. Atomic radii or the ionic radii, both increases from top to bottom, because in case of oxygen, that belongs to the second period, that is second orbit is the valence shell, whereas in case of tellurium, that belongs to the fifth period, hence it is fifth orbit is the valence shell. Here, from top to bottom, number of valence shells are increasing. As the number of valence shells are increasing, automatically the distance present between the nucleus and the outer orbit is also increasing, thus atomic radius increases. Thus, the size, if you consider, compared to oxygen, sulfur is bigger, compared to sulfur, selenium and tellurium is still bigger. But whereas, in case of the oxygen and in case of the sulfur, what happens is, only s orbitals related, p orbitals related electrons are there. The s and p electrons are having more shielding effect. Due to this reason, what happens is, in between this oxygen and the sulfur, whatever the gap is there, that gap is highest. But whereas from here onwards, d orbital electrons are there, d orbital electrons are there, and next f orbital electrons are there. These are not that much shielders. Hence, they are not protecting the nuclear attractions. So, therefore, here size decreases. Whereas here in between these, the size gap between oxygen and sulfur is highest. And then after, you will find a small gap between sulfur, selenium, selenium, tellurium, and all other elements. Thus, in general, size is increasing from top to bottom. Highest size is present for the tellurium, lowest is present for the oxygen. The size gap is highest in case of in between of oxygen and the sulfur, because the oxygen and the sulfur are consisting just only s and the p black electrons. These are acting as good shielders. If they protect the nuclear attractions nicely, then what happens? Interactions of the nucleus over the outer orbit decreases. Thus, it extends like this, compared to the expected position. It is present far away from the nucleus. As a result, the distance increases. Thus, atomic radius gap increases between oxygen as well as the sulfur. Metallic character, the ability to lose the electrons, the ability of the conduction. Metallic character increases from top to bottom because the size of the atom increases, nuclear attractions decreases, removal of electrons becomes very easy. So therefore, metallic character increases from top to bottom. Out of these 5 elements, oxygen, sulfur maintains one particular property. These are non-metals, whereas selenium, tellurium are having intermediate metal and the non-metal properties. Hence, these are said to be metalloids, and polonium is acting as a metal. Whereas the semi-metals or metalloids are having metal as well as non-metallic properties. These are also acting as semiconductors. Those are selenium as well as the tellurium. Polonium is metal, but this metal is radioactive metal. Hence, very little is known about this one. And it is very short half-life containing system. Thus, they maintain a trend that 2:2:1 out of 5 elements of eligible discussion, first 2 are non-metals, remaining 2 are metalloids, and also acting as being metalloids are acting as semiconductors. Last one is metal, but it is radioactive, and it is very short half-life containing radioactive element. melting and boiling points. These are depends on the intermolecular force of attraction. As the intermolecular force of attraction increases, automatically melting and the boiling points increases. This intermolecular force of attraction depends on the size. As the size increases, then attractions of one molecule with the other molecule increases. That is known as intermolecular force of attraction. Thus, what happens is, in general, intermolecular force of attraction increases. So, as a result, melting and boiling points also increases. But there is a difference with respect to polonium. Polonium is maintaining crystal structure due to different arrangement of crystals, different arrangement of lattice points of polonium atoms in the space lattice. Here it maintains lower melting point as well as the lower boiling point, then abnormally from the trend. Thus, melting point of all the elements increases, but polonium maintains somewhat lower melting point than the tellurium. Similarly, boiling points of all the elements increases, but here also the polonium maintains lower boiling point than the tellurium. Thus, melting and boiling point trend is like this. Compared to oxygen, sulfur is having higher. Compared to sulfur, selenium is having higher. Compared to selenium, tellurium is having higher. But polonium comes in between selenium as well as the tellurium in case of both melting point as well as the boiling point. Ionization potential, the energy required to remove the electron from the gases atom is known as ionization energy, and whereas this energy required is depends on the intermolecular, depends on the attraction present between the nucleus and the electrons in the electrons of the outermost orbit. That is, can be measured with the help of Z-effective. That is, Z-effective stands for the net interaction strength of nucleus over the outermost electrons. As Z-effective increases, attraction strength increases. Z-effective decreases, attraction strength decreases. But it is observed in case of 6A group elements that the Z-effective value decreases because size increases, number of orbits increases, shielding effect increases. So therefore, the Z-effective decreases. As Z-effective decreases, net interaction strength of nucleus over the outer orbit decreases. Thus, removal of electrons becomes easy. Hence, the required energy also becomes less. Thus, with lesser energy, by providing lesser amount of energy, removal of electrons takes place. Thus, ionization potential decreases in case of the 6A group elements. That is, compared to oxygen, sulfur is requiring lesser ionization energy than selenium and then tellurium. In this way, the trend is maintained related to the 6A group elements. And as a relative comparison of ionization energy of the 5A group elements as well as the 6A group elements and along with the 7A group elements also, fluorine, chlorine, bromine and the iodine. Here what happens, once again, size decreases implies what? Corresponding this particular ionization energy of the 7A groups are higher compared to the 6A. But here the same trend is maintained, not maintained here, because nitrogen family is off-field configuration. So therefore, it requires highest energy to break the symmetrical distribution of the electrons. To make that one free from the off-field configuration, it takes extra energy. So therefore, ionization energy here also decreases from top to bottom, here also decreases from top to bottom. But of the corresponding elements, if you look at, compare it to nitrogen, oxygen is maintaining lower ionization energy, and compare it to fluorine also, oxygen maintains the lower ionization energy. In every group of the oxygen family, of the nitrogen family, of the halogen family, ionization potential decreases from top to bottom. Thus, you will find, compared to oxygen, sulfur, compared to sulfur, selenium, compared to selenium, tellurium maintains lowest value of ionization potential. Next one is electron affinity. Gaseous atom, after taking electron, it is converted to gaseous anion, followed by what? Some amount of energy will be liberated. That liberated amount of energy is reference. Liberated amount of energy is criteria for deciding of the electron affinity. The more energy liberated, more electron affinity. The less energy liberated, less electron affinity. And once again, the energy content liberated when an electron is added to the atom depends on attractions of nucleus over the incoming electron. the more attractions, more energy is liberated, the less attractions, less energy is liberated. Once again, that is studied with the help of what? Z effective. As we know, Z effective decreases. So therefore, electron affinity also decreases. But there is another one factor that can influence the electron affinity is electron density present in the outermost orbit. If it is having more electrons in the outermost orbit within the small space, then more electron density is there, then incoming electron and the present electrons will face repulsions. To overcome the repulsions, more amount of energy is expended over there. So therefore, liberated amount of energy decreases. So as far as Z effective is concerned, Z effective decreases, net attractions decreases, as a result electron affinity should decrease. So therefore, what we will expect is, compared to oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, polonium, this kind of trend has to be maintained. But abnormally, in case of these, what happens is, oxygen is having two lone pairs, so it is facing a lot of repulsions within the valence shell. It is not ready to accept the another one electron coming from the outside. As a result, here lot of amount of energy is utilized for that purpose to make the electron adjust in the outermost orbit of the electron, outermost orbit of the oxygen. Lot of amount of energy is consumed over there, so net amount of energy liberated will be small. It is small to an extent that it will be little compared to sulfur, selenium, tellurium, polonium, and the next position will come for the oxygen. So therefore, electron affinity, the amount of energy that is liberated when an electron is added to the gaseous atom in case of 6A group elements, though follows the trend, but abnormality is maintained with respect to the oxygen because it is having higher valence electron density. Due to this reason, trend is sulfur followed by selenium, tellurium, polonium, and the last one is what? Oxygen maintains. The reason is electron density in the valence shell. Electron activity, it is the ability of the atom to withdraw the sigma bond electron density with the connected other atom. Suppose out of A and B, suppose if A is more electronegative, this sigma bond electron density is partially shifted towards A, and we will represent that one as partial negative and the partial positive charges. We can say A is having more electronegativity. Whereas this also depends on the attraction ability of the atom for the bonded electron. So that also depends on attraction strength of nucleus over the outermost orbit. That is once again given by the help of Z effective. That Z effective decreases from top to bottom, so therefore electronegativity also decreases. Thus the trend maintained is electronegativity of oxygen is greater than sulfur, and sulfur is greater than selenium, selenium is greater than tellurium, and tellurium is greater than the polonium. Such kind of regular trend is maintained in case of electronegativity of the 6A group elements. Catenation, the ability of self-linkage of atoms with itself is said to be the catenation. It depends on the bond strength. If you look at the bond strength related to the 6A group elements, oxygen bond strength is 213, whereas the sulfur bond strength is 412, and bond strength is goes on decreasing. Why oxygen is maintaining less bond strength? Because here oxygen is associated with the lone pair of electrons, two smaller atoms having lone pair of electrons. They repel with one another if they come somewhat close. As a result, they don't want to come towards most close. So as a result, bond length increases, bond strength decreases, bond energy also decreases. Due to this particular reason, oxygen-oxygen connectivity is not strengthened enough. Thus, the catenation ability, which in turn depends on the bond energy, catenation ability of oxygen is little, because what, it is associated with the minimum size followed by lone pair of electrons. Thus, oxygen can form double bond, that is O2 is there, O3 is there, and also we are having peroxides in which two oxygen atoms maximum can be connected with one another. But if you look at the sulfur, sulfur S8 molecules are available. Already we made the discussion, that is Packard ring structure. S6 molecules are available, this is also cyclic chair conformation. Along with this, sulfides are there, polysulfides are there, similar to hydrogen peroxide. Here H2S2 is there, H2S3 is there, H2S4 is there. Thus, in the periodic table, the highest catenation ability is present for the carbon. The next highest is present for the sulfur. And in the 6th A group elements, the highest catenation ability is present for the sulfur because it is associated with the highest bond energy, and the catenation ability decreases from top to bottom because bond energy goes on decreasing. Allotropes, the different physical forms of the substances with having same chemical properties are said to be allotropes to one another. Whereas oxygen is having two gaseous allotropes, one is normal oxygen followed by ozone. Sulfur is having allotropic forms, that is rhombic sulfur, monoclinic sulfur as well as the plastic sulfur. Selenium maintains two allotropic forms, one is red in color, that is non-metallic in nature, and second one is gray in color, that is metallic in nature. This gray is very important, it is acting as photoconductor, hence it is used in photoelectric cells. The next one is tellurium, it is also having two allotropes, one is crystalline allotrope and second one is amorphous. And polonium also maintains allotropes like alpha and beta forms, both are metallic in nature. Thus all the elements of the 6th A group elements are maintaining allotropes. Oxidation state, the imaginary charge present over the atom after breaking all connectivities is said to be the oxidation state. Whereas that oxidation states are of three varieties because it is maintaining a trend of electronegativity from higher value to lower value. So therefore it can combine with any variety of the element. On behalf of that, its oxidation state can be either zero, positive, negative. Zero state is possible whenever the element combines with the same element, that is oxygen combination with oxygen, sulfur combination with the sulfur, that is zero state combination with same element. So this is a special case, not eligible for that much discussion. Whereas positive and negative oxidation states, negative oxidation state trend is generally higher for the more electronegative elements. The electronegativity decreases from top to bottom, so therefore trend related to the negative oxidation state is higher for oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium and polonium if you take. So polonium is not taken into account. So oxygen is having higher ability to show the negative oxidation state, and the negative oxidation state trend decreases from top to bottom. Whereas positive oxidation state, here also we are having oxygen, sulfur and the tellurium. In this case, the positive oxidation state trend is increases from top to bottom. Now in detail we will discuss with respect to each element what will happen to the oxidation state. Especially oxygen is very important, when oxygen shows which oxidation state and what are possible, with which element it shows positive, with which elements it shows negative. Similarly for sulfur and all other possible positive oxidation state and the inert pair effect. Once again, the negative possible oxidation states are in general, that is -2, whereas positive oxidation states are +2, +4 and +6. Zero state is unique state, that is 0. Whereas negative is possible if it gains another 2 electrons, because the general electronic configuration is NS2NP4 as per the Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity, as per the Pauli's filling of the electronic levels as per the energy levels are concerned, this is NS2 followed by NP4. Here if it gains another 2 electrons, it will be -2. Whereas if it loses its electrons, this will be +2. And if it loses 2 plus another 2 electrons, this will be +4. Another these 2 electrons are also, if it left, then it is accommodating an oxidation number of +6. Thus oxidation states of minus are general, -2 is the oxidation state, and the positive oxidation states are +2, +4 and +6. And from top to bottom, the inert pair effect increases due to increment in nature of inert pair effect. The tendency to show highest possible oxidation state also decreases. Thus, what happens is, in case of polonium, that is highest possible oxidation state, highest possible oxidation state, trend related to the highest possible oxidation state. Suppose oxygen, sulfur, you leave sulfur, selenium and the tellurium if you take. Whereas from top to bottom generally positive oxidation state trend goes on increasing. But the highest possible oxidation state trend decreases because here what happens is inert pair effect. Inert pair effect is present. Due to this inert pair effect, these paired electrons are not interested to participate in excitation. As a result, higher possible oxidation states like plus 6 and plus 4 can't be shown by this particular tellurium element, and thus tendency of showing highest possible oxidation state is higher for the sulfur, selenium, etc. Now let us go for the oxygen related oxidation states and the sulfur related oxidation states. Yes, the oxidation states of oxygen and the sulfur. Oxygen, the general electronic configuration is NS2NP4, whereas oxygen is 2S2 2P4. It is not having 2D orbital, hence paired electron of 2P can't be promoted, hence it is restricted to the valence shell electronic configuration of 2S2 2P4, that is 2PX2 followed by 2PY1 and 2PZ1. It also shows different varieties of oxidation states. Here the meaning of saying of this one is, it can't extend oxidation number. It shows lower oxidation state. It is not going for the oxidation states like 2 unpaired electrons related oxidation states it will shows. That is in between minus 2 to plus 2. It never extends above 4, above 2, that is 4 and 6 can't be shown by the oxygen. And within that limited also it shows two different varieties of oxidation states. Some of them are positive, some of them are negative. Negative are once again two varieties. One is integral oxidation state and second one is fractional oxidation state. This negative state is shown when oxygen is chemically combined with less electropositive element. That is, suppose hydrogen. In water, oxidation state of hydrogen is plus 1, so therefore oxygen is minus 2. In hydrogen peroxide, oxidation state of oxygen is minus 1. Similarly, fractional oxidation state is shown by oxygen in case of superoxides followed by what? Ozonides. Suppose KO2, which is known as potassium superoxide, two oxygens are having minus 1 as the state, each oxygen is maintaining minus 1 by 2. And in ozonides, here this oxygen is maintaining minus 1 by 3 is the oxidation state. Whereas positive oxidation state is shown by oxygen when it combines with relatively more electronegative element, and that is just fluorine, no other element. With dioxygen difluoride, it shows plus 1. With oxygen difluoride, it shows plus 2. These are the different varieties of oxidation states shown by the oxygen. Let us go for sulfur. Sulfur is having 3s2. 3p4 followed by 3d0 electronic configuration. So therefore here it is having 3s2 and here it is having 3p4 followed by 3d orbital is vacant. So therefore it can promote its electron from the 3p orbitals to the 3d orbitals. Thus it can show maximum oxidation state, that is more than 2, that is 4 and 6 can be shown by the sulfur. Whereas here with the less electropositive elements, it shows negative oxidation state, and that is suppose H2S, it shows minus 2 as the oxidation state. With more electronegative elements, it shows the negative oxidation state. So therefore SCl2 in this sulfur is showing plus 2 is the state. If this electron is promoted from here to d orbital, and if this electron is promoted here to another d orbital, in that case it is having 4 unpaired electrons in case 1 and 6 unpaired electrons in case 2. Under that condition, if it is combined with the more electronegative elements, generally it combines with more electronegative element, because more electronegative element only releases energy and that promotes the electron from the lower oxidation state to the higher oxidation state. Thus, it shows plus 4 as well as the plus 6 oxidation states. Thus, it is clear that oxygen shows within the limits of minus 2 to plus 2. whereas sulfur shows from -2 to +6 all varieties of oxidation states. But generally the sulfur oxidation states are integral oxidation states, that is -2, +2, +4, and +6 states. Whatever the fractional states are there, these are for understanding of the things. There is inversionally to say there is no fractional oxidation state. To know the information in a clear version, to not to get any kind of confusion, for more than one elements, a combined situation related oxidation state is taken as reference and is known as common fractional oxidation state. Multiple bonds, that is along with the sigma bonds, the possible other bond is pi bonds. That is, there are two varieties of pi bonds. One is p pi bond, and second one is, here electron is promoted to the d orbital, hence the second is d pi p pi bond, and d pi bond is very rare case that is not eligible for the discussion. Whereas let us go for the oxygen can form all varieties of bonds. That is, it is smaller atom, so it can form p pi bond. It can also forms p pi and the other elements related d orbital can also be involved. Suppose let us go for carbon dioxide structure. In this carbon dioxide, this p pi and the p pi bond formation is possible between carbon as well as the oxygen. Similarly, in O2 molecule also p pi bonding ability is there. If I go for the other elements, like not only this carbon dioxide, not only for the oxygen, some other element which is having a empty d orbital in which one unpaired electron is there, with that also if it is combined, it can form p pi d pi bonds. Whereas the pi bond formation ability is high for the oxygen because it is smaller. Let us go for the sulfur. Sulfur is not interested to form p pi bond, but it can form p pi d pi bonds. That is, d orbital of this particular sulfur atom and the p orbital of another atom when combines with one another, that it leads to the formation of p pi d pi bond. Suppose carbon disulfide, in this p orbital and the d orbital of the sulfur combines laterally and leads to the formation of p pi d pi bonds. Whereas this p pi d pi bond formation ability is present to certain extent to the selenium. Suppose similar to that of carbon disulfide, carbon diselenide is also present, but it is unstable. So here also p pi and the d pi bond formation is present. Whereas this particular tendency of forming p pi and d pi bond strength is not present for the tellurium. Thus what we can say is the ability to form the multiple bonds, though that may be any variety of bond, p pi bond or p pi d pi bond or d pi bond, ability decreases from top to bottom. That's what oxygen can form the multiple bonds. To certain extent, sulfur can form the multiple bonds. But the ability to form the multiple bonds with the other atoms goes on decreasing from top to bottom. Next is reactivity. Reactivity is chemical reactivity. Suppose let us go for A is an element, its reactivity like this. In AB, if it is reacted with C, it is converted to AC. The reactivity of A in this particular case depends on the bond energy of AB that is going to be broken and the bond energy of AC that is going to be formed. And once again, this particular bond energies are depends on ionization potential, electron affinity, electronegativity, and all other things. Thus, in spite of these of all things, it is observed practically that the reactivity of oxygen is highest, then after it is coming for the sulfur, then selenium and the tellurium. So therefore, the order of reactivity is oxygen is more reactive because bond energy is little, then sulfur, then selenium and the tellurium. Reactivity is present in such a way, highest reactivity is maintained for the first element, the same trend is maintained, then sulfur, then selenium, then tellurium. Irrespective of bond energies, the reactivity order is highest for oxygen, then sulfur, selenium as well as the tellurium.